Cicadas feed on trees. They're not tree killers, and their young have to feed on those same trees on which they're hatching. Overall, not a probably a great concern, but until you get a sense of how many numbers might be appearing in your yard, it's really hard to say how much risk there is in your given location. If you look around the soil level, and if it's in your grass, you may just feel it underfoot. You'll have little emergence holes like the size of a thumb, and some of these may actually have a small chimney, maybe an inch or two high. And if you feel those underfoot or you visually see those in the ground, you get a sense of the numbers that may potentially hatch in your area. I would say trees, not so much shrubs, but trees that were recently planted last year or in the last few years are relatively young, might be more vulnerable and might incur a greater amount of damage than you might tolerate. But established and mature trees, you may even see some drooping and maybe some dieback in some branches, but it won't be enough to really hurt the health of the tree. You can protect the trees that you feel are valuable or need protecting. The key with that is to use the proper material. It's recommended you use a nylon net, not a mesh or a sheet, but a nylon net. You want the openings less than a half inch in size. It allows air and sunlight through, and moisture is needed. And you just lightly lay the netting over your plant, very lightly, and just secure it around the trunk. Doesn't have to be super tight. Don't be overly concerned about, this appearance of this great emergence. Now, there can be very many in a very concentrated space. You can find thousands in a small footprint, as we did at the Botanical Gardens. But it's such a very unusual and fascinating event, and it literally occurs only every 17 odd years. And so it's a natural cycle that's been going on for thousands, if not millions of years. And I guess learn not to be afraid of the insects in general, but especially cicadas. And the more you learn about this event, I think the more fascinated you'll become, and you may have a great appreciation for the biology of the insect and its place in the natural world.